Hey everybody, welcome to Face the Music. I'm your host, Dave. So glad that you're here. And just want to say real quick, for those of you who've been with me on this channel for a while, thank you so much. Thanks for sticking around. For those of you who are recent new subscribers, thanks so much for joining this great community. And if you're not a subscriber, let me just ask you to do this. Just reach on over. I'll give you a minute. Just reach on over and hit that subscribe button. It's very easy. Very easy. Just hit that subscribe button and you'll automatically become a member of this great community. So I'll give you a second. Okay, sure you did it. Okay, great. So now we've got you joined, and let me just say we're a great community of music lovers who just want to do nothing but just keep all this great music alive for this generation and for all the generations to come. So that said, like I said, you know, thanks for subscribing, and make sure that you also get your notifications set up so that whenever I drop a video, that you'll also be notified and you'll be able to enjoy it as soon as it gets dropped, right? Okay, so for today's episode, let me just say this. So I just did a journey episode, a journey video just the other day. And normally I don't like to do two videos in a row of the same artist. And I normally like to just, you know, go from one to the other, just kind of move around, give a little bit of variety. But so lately I've been actually listening to the audiobook from Jonathan Cain, who for years was the keyboardist for Journey. And as I was listening to his audiobook and I was listening to his stories about the songs and all that. And later on, I was listening to some Journey songs, and this song came on as one of the songs that I, you know, was listening to, and I love it. I absolutely love it. It's Open Arms. For those of you who have never heard this song before, let me just say for Journey, I talked a little bit in the last episode about how, you know, Steve Perry wasn't the original. Well, I mean, I don't think I mentioned this in the very last episode, but for those of you who don't know, Steve Perry was not the original vocalist for Journey. For those of you who know the band, you know this already. But when Steve left, and Steve was the one who really, I think, kickstarted the whole Journey phenomena. I mean, it wasn't until Journey, until Steve Perry took over as lead singer, that Journey's success really in the 80s really took off. Now, when Steve left, Steve Augeri took over. And then, you know, later on, of course, you've got the current iteration with Arnel Pineda. Now, Steve Augeri, Arnel Pineda, in their own right, they're really, really good. And I'm not going to take anything away from either one of those guys. But let me just say this. And I think maybe many of you may feel the same way. As far as I'm concerned, there is no Journey without Steve Perry. Steve Perry is, as I mentioned before, he is the voice. That was the nickname given to him by none other than John Bon Jovi because of how fantastic he is in his voice and in his singing. And this song was a song that Jonathan Cain, the keyboardist for Journey, he wrote when he was originally with his original band, The Babies. And John Waite, the lead singer of that band, really didn't think it was going to fit with the Babies' recording style. So he didn't, you know, take that song on. Jonathan Cain kept it. And later on when he joined Journey, he brought it to Steve Perry. Steve loved it. Now, initially, the rest of the band really didn't know what to do with the song because it's a ballad and they really weren't into ballads at that time. So they were kind of like, we're not sure what to do with this. But, you know, Steve loved it. And as you know, Journey had a lot of great ballads. Especially in the 80s, and Steve Perry's voice soared on every single one of them, you know, from Send Her My Love to Faithfully, of course, and then, of course, to this song, Open Arms. So, and if you have ever been to a Journey concert, now, I have been to one, I think I mentioned this before, I went to one back a number of years ago. It was a concert with Styx, Journey, and REO Speedwagon. Now, this was post-Steve Perry day, so Steve Augeri was there, and again, the Journey concert that night was good. But it just wasn't the same. And I've never been able to be at a concert where Steve Perry was the performer because I missed all those days. But I get to live kind of, you know, a little bit of what it was like just by watching these videos. Now, if you've ever been to a Journey concert when Steve Perry was still lead singer, maybe this concert that we're going to see tonight in our footage or in any other shows, let me know. A lot of you have been writing messages, emails, messages, comments in the videos, and letting me know your experiences with some of the artists, especially, you know, like with the Bee Gees before, and then, of course, Pink Floyd lately, and Steve Perry and Journey and one of the other videos that we did. So, you know, if you have experiences, I love to read all those comments. I love to read those emails, so keep them coming. I do read each and every one of them. And like I say, I do try to feature live concert footage in on this channel, because I think that it's really important to get to see, not only get to hear the songs, the great songs, but get to see the artists, especially as they were back in the day performing them. I try to find videos that I think will probably represent that. Some videos I get a chance to see all the way through before I show it here, and other videos I don't. I just know that it's going to be, you know, if it says, hey, it's from 1983 or something, I know, hey, this is the Journey iteration of the group that I know existed at that time, so it's going to be fantastic. And so, anyways, no more talking. Let's just go ahead and jump right into it. Here's Journey and their fantastic song, Open Arms.
Effortlessly. Wow. This. Big smile from Neil right there. Yep.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
That, of course, was Journey and Open Arms. That footage was actually live from Budokan in 1983. And let me tell you, you know, like I say, those guys had felt like they just, you know, just struck gold when Steve Perry came on board. You know, and I get it that, you know, initially because they were a different type of band, you know, they didn't really want to get into all the ballads and stuff initially until I think they realized that what kind of a voice and the magic that Steve Perry actually brought to the band. You know, I think initially Neil Sean wasn't really that excited. He's like, what am I going to do with a ballad? You know, you can see him playing guitar on that song. Fantastic. He just nails it. And I think that they really grew more into themselves the more songs like that, that they, you know, that they performed, that Steve and John wrote. You know, you see Jonathan Cain there on the keyboards, you know, the composer of most, a lot of those songs that him and Steve Perry wrote together for the band, you know, just fantastic. And like I said, you can have today's music when it comes to a lot of the songs, you know, and I get it. And there's a few songs here and there that, I mean, I might be like, hey, that's pretty catchy. Get it. Okay. But I just don't think that in most of today's music, you have the same soul, you have the same I don't have to be, going out there and doing all kinds of, crazy things and gimmicks to be successful. That's exactly what Steve Perry, that's the way that he performed. That's the way he came across, was just, I'm going to go out there, I'm going to give it my best, and I'm just going to stand there and belt it out, and you be the judge of how good it is. I think after all these years and how successful the band is, was, is, and will be in the future, I think it's very apparent, that he brought some magic to that band that very few bands, if any at all, really have ever experienced or will ever experience again. Just fantastic. And like I say, if you've ever been to any of those shows with Steve Perry, put it in the comments, send me an email. My email address is in the description box below. Let me know your experiences. Like I say, when I saw the band, it was just with Steve Augeri, still great in his own right. But unfortunately, I have to say, no Steve Perry. Okay. So, anyways, that's it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't subscribed yet, like I say, please subscribe. Share this channel with your family, friends, coworkers, whoever you know. We want to grow this community into a great big community of people who want to, who enjoy this music, share and want to share all this great music, not only with this generation, but with all the generations to come. Okay? So that's it for today. I'll see you next time right here on Face the Music. Take care.